This week's video focuses on choosing good initial estimates in monoliths. Before estimating the population parameters of a structural model, it is possible to specify initial values for these parameters in the tab Initial Estimates for the fixed effects, for the standard deviation of the random effects, and for the residual error parameters. This has several advantages. First, this is a step where the modeler can bring some knowledge about the system to guide the estimation of the parameters. Second, by choosing initial estimates that are close to the final solution, the convergence of the estimation algorithm will be greatly accelerated. When initializing the project, the values are set by default to 1. To change it, I can click on the arrow or use the keyboard. I can see a message that warns me of potential constraints for the value based on the statistical model that I have chosen for this parameter. When a parameter depends on a covariate, for example, V on sex, the dependency is modeled with a new parameter beta. Default initial value for this parameter is 0 and can be changed as well. In addition to choosing initial values, on this panel I can select the method of estimation for each parameter. Maximum likelihood estimation is the default, but I can also fix the parameter or choose maximum a posteriori estimation for a Bayesian approach. There are also buttons to fix all the parameters or none. It is recommended to let the default values of 1 for omega parameters rather than setting lower initial standard effects, because the estimation algorithm SAEM performs better with high initial variabilities that allow to explore a large domain. In contrast, choosing specific initial values for the fixed effect is important. This is guided with the subtab Check Initial Estimates. In this panel, the chosen values are used to simulate population predictions that are displayed in red on top of the individual data in blue. The values can be incremented or decremented with the arrows and the increment step on the right, or can be changed directly with the keyboard. You can see that the population predictions are updated in real time while I change the values for the initial estimates. My goal here is then to find initial values that fit roughly the individual data in order to speed up the convergence. I can adapt the visualization with a log scale or by setting the same limits for all the individuals to compare them more easily, and I can browse through the individuals of the dataset with these pages here. If it seems that there are not enough points for the prediction, if there are many doses, for example, like here, I can change the discretization and increase the number of points. Once I'm happy with the values I have chosen, I can accept them by clicking on Set as Initial Values. I can then run the population parameter estimation. The estimated population parameters can then be seen in the tab Results. I can use them as initial values for the next run with the button Use Last Estimates. I can use all the last estimates or only the fixed effects to avoid reducing the standard effects. If I now change the structural model, for example, I want to add a PD part and switch from a one-compartment model to a two-compartment model, then the initial estimates are kept for parameters with the same name, so CL has the same initial value as before. The PD part of the model is linked to a second type of observations in the dataset. The plot to check the initial estimate for this part can be found by changing the output to Y2. The volume V has been replaced by two parameters V1 and V2, so I have to set initial values for these two. Of course, the fit doesn't have to be perfect, but it is recommended at least to choose initial values that will show the main properties of the model on the curves. For example, here, for a two-compartment model, it is important to see the two phases of elimination, because the impact of the parameters on each phase will guide the convergence of the fit. This is particularly important for models that display complex kinetics, such as TMDD models. On our online documentation, you can find guidelines that not only help to choose between models from the TMDD library, but that also explain which parameters impact each property of the curve and what are the typical values for each parameter that can be used as initial estimates. Projects with non-continuous data, with the observation type that is either discrete or event like here, do not have this Check Initial Estimate tab. In that case as well, we rely on guidelines that are available on the online documentation for typical parameter values for the models of the TTE library. For example, looking at the shape of the Kaplan-Meier plot for this time-to-event data, I can see that the exponential model from the library should be a good fit. The guidelines for a typical value for the parameter TE is also written in the exponential model from the library. It should be close to the time at which a survival reaches 0.4. This is close to 100 in this dataset, so 100 is a good initial estimate for TE and results in a fast convergence. This is it for initial estimates. Enjoy these Monolix features in your own projects.